In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Welcome this morning as we gather for our Mass on this 13th Sunday in the year. We gather here from the church in Kilcloon, the church of St. Oliver Plunkett, appropriately that as during the coming week we celebrate the feast of St. Oliver Plunkett. And this was the first of the churches dedicated to St. Oliver after his canonization back in 1974. We gather today in prayer and we welcome you wherever you join us from to celebrate with us in prayer in this Sunday Mass. Jesus reminds us today in the Gospel that we are sent on a mission. We are sent bearing his name. So all who know us ought to know Christ because we carry with us the person and love and presence of Jesus Christ. As we gather today for our Mass, we celebrate that gift of Christ's presence in our lives, that life-giving presence, that presence of his love, his strength, his peace, his hope. And as we prepare ourselves to celebrate the Mass, let us call to mind our own failings and ask the Lord for his pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of the light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second book of the Kings. One day, as Elisha was on his way to Shunem, a woman of rank who lived there pressed him to stay and eat there. After this, he always broke his journey for a meal when he passed that way. She said to her husband, "Look, I am sure the man who is constantly passing our way must be a holy man of God. Let us build him a small room on the roof and put him a bed in it and a table and a chair and a lamp. Whenever he comes to us, he can rest there." One day when he came, he retired to the upper room and lay down. "What can be done for her?" he asked. Gehazi, his servant, answered, "Well, she has no son, and her husband is old." Elisha said, "Call her." The servant called her, and she stood at the door. "This time next year," Elisha said, "you will hold a son in your arms." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. When we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized in his death. In other words, when we were baptized, we went into the tomb with him and joined him in death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the Father's glory, we too might live a new life. But we believe that having died with Christ, we shall return to life with him. Christ, as we know, having been raised from the dead, will never die again. Death has no power over him anymore. When he died once for all to sin, so his life now is life with God. And in that way, you too must consider yourselves to be dead to sin, but alive for God in Christ Jesus. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus instructed the 12 as follows. Anyone who prefers father or mother to me is not worthy of me. Anyone who prefers son or daughter to me is not worthy of me. Anyone who does not take his cross and follow in my footsteps is not worthy of me. Anyone who finds his life will lose it. Anyone who loses his life for my sake will find it. Anyone who welcomes you welcomes me, and those who welcome me welcome the one who sent me. Anyone who welcomes a prophet because he is a prophet will have a prophet's reward. And anyone who welcomes a holy man because he is a holy man will have a holy man's reward. If anyone gives so much as a cup of cold water to one of these little ones because he is a disciple, then I tell you solemnly, he will most certainly not lose his reward. The Gospel of the Lord. I'm sure that we all can remember well when we were younger and traveling or visiting friends or relations with our parents, that there was always special people or places we would prefer to go. They would normally be the ones where we would get the most hospitality, that extra treat, maybe a few bob, something special to take home with us. These were the places where we would prefer to visit. We are treated with hospitality because of who we are. And hospitality is not just an exclusively Irish gift. It is something that we find throughout the world. As Jesus continues to instruct his disciples on the gift of their mission, he speaks of that lesson of hospitality. But hospitality that is a wide and inclusive of all. It's a hospitality that will leave behind maybe even our own family comforts. A hospitality that can welcome even our moments or times of suffering because other people will benefit. Because it will bring blessings to others. Because it spreads the gift and the word of Christ. For the faith that Christ teaches us is not a faith that is self-centered. It is not privatized. It is for all people. It recognizes the needs of the other. That may be taking up the cross each day, the needs of the other person, through hospitality, through care, through compassion, through the daily needs that we meet in our lives for those around about us, those who call on our help, our assistance. No doubt, during the past 3 months of lockdown, we have been missing our usual activities, and we gladly welcome that gradual return of liberty and movement, returning to normal activity, even looking forward to having our congregations return to the churches for Mass. But during that time, the Lord's work of charity continued in a very evident and powerful way through the gift of hospitality and care, the gift of wanting to see that everybody was taken care of and looked after. Despite not having been able to attend the liturgy and receive the Eucharist, there was and is a communion with the Lord through these acts that are done. This is the Lord's hospitality, his welcome, his openness to us, where it brings new life. We're asked by the Gospel, and indeed the story of the prophet in the first reading shows hospitality for all, stranger as well as friend, those who are not the same nationality, creed, or color as we are, but a hospitality to all. That understanding of hospitality to be broadened. It is a culture that may have changed in some ways over the past, but when we welcome Christ, it's not just because he is a nice man to know. It's welcoming Christ who brings to us that way of life, the commandments, the teachings, the example. It may disrupt our own life comforts, but it is a way through which we carry the cross with Christ, and he carries it with us. as he used that phrase, or instruction that those who wish to carry the cross with him, it's not a very comforting analogy, but it is something that we need to be aware of as followers of Christ. It was Saint Teresa of Avila who spoke of the great mission that each of us had as Christian brothers and sisters to do the work, to be the person of Christ. For Christ has no body now but yours. Christ has no hands now but yours. He has no feet now but yours. Yours are the eyes through which he looks with compassion on the world. Yours are the hands with which he blesses the world. So as he reminded us, we bring Christ. People welcome us because we bring Christ. We bring that blessing with us. It is the presence of the Lord. So as that mission that we receive is one to which we find the presence of the Lord in our lives and we bring it and share it and live it, may we be strengthened on our journey, receiving and opening ourselves to the hospitality that is for the Word of God, and the hospitality which brings the hope and the presence and the joy of Christ to our world at this present time. We make our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in his generous compassion, we turn to the Father and voice our petitions as we pray.
For the Church, that we who have died with Christ in baptism may recognize our dignity in being children of God and sisters and brothers to one another, Lord, hear us.
Lord graciously hear us.
For the grace of hospitality, that we may welcome all who enter our lives as we would welcome Christ with great love and generously. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the grace of perseverance, that God will give strength and hope to all who suffer because they practice the values and principles of the gospel. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the grace to live the gospel, that we may love God with our whole heart and strength, and learn to love everyone in our lives as God loves them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For Pope Francis and all who will benefit from the Peter's Pence collection, that God will strengthen and sustain him and help him to be able to respond to all who request his assistance during times of famine, disease, or disaster. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all who care for the sick, that God will give them strength and help them be instruments of healing and compassion. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all youth, that God will guide them through the challenges and confusion of these days and help them grow to the fullest potential. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. And we remember in quiet prayer our own special intentions today in our Mass. Lord, hear us. We remember all our faithful departed. Today, especially in our Mass, we remember in prayer John and Rosalind Renahan, Sarah Ann Hurley, Margaret and Ulrich MacDonald, and their daughter Helen, whose anniversaries occur around this time. We pray that all who have died in Christ will rise with him in new life. Lord, hear us. Loving Father, we praise you with all our heart, for you have rescued us. Preserve us, protect us, change our mourning into dancing. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good, the good of all his holy church. O God, who graciously accomplish the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world, that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that, by sinning, we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present among us when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask you to send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, On the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the offering of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis our Pope and Tom our Bishop, Michael our retired Bishop, with all bishops, priests and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when the earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with her spouse Saint Joseph, with the apostles and martyrs, Saint Oliver Plunkett, and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Kingdom, the power and the glory are now. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Anyone who prefers father, mother, son, or daughter to me is not worthy of me. Maybe Jesus seems very self-important when he says that nothing must be preferred to him. You cannot prefer mother or father, son or daughter, or your own life over Jesus. Surely he is not devaluing family relations or life itself. Maybe it's something like this. That even the most valued things of life, family and life itself, are not as lasting as his friendship. Son or daughter can leave you, may die. So may father and mother, brother, sister, friend. But Jesus lasts, the Word of God, Son of God, Bread of Life. Anyone who prefers father, mother, son, or daughter to me is not worthy of me. Let us pray. O Lord, may this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, we pray, so that, bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. So today at our Mass, we remember especially John and Rosalind Renahan, Sarah Ann Hurley, and Margaret and Ulick MacDonald and their daughter Helen, whose anniversaries are around this time. We also pray for the repose of the soul of Father Patrick Keary, the former priest of this parish who died this morning, and retired parish priest of Clara, County Offaly. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. May perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. And this morning you may have seen a few snaps of places throughout the parish. Maybe you recognized somewhere close to your own home the different lanes and roadways through the parish. And Sarah got a new kitten, so she sent in her photograph there to show. Like many others, new pets are flavor of the month. As you already know, I'm sure, that the removal of some restrictions from the lockdown period are beginning to be removed at this time. And gladly, from tomorrow onwards, churches can welcome back congregations into their church for the celebration of Mass. However, to ensure social distancing and following the guidelines laid down by the HSE and government departments, numbers will be limited. But to facilitate as many as we can here for our Masses, we will use only the church here in Kilcloon, as it allows for the most space and the most persons to attend, both for weekday and weekend Masses. Our weekend schedule will return next weekend as it previously was, as in we have Mass at 6:30 on Saturday evening, our Vigil Mass, 9:30 and 11:30 a.m. Mass here on Sunday mornings. And weekday Mass is also here on Monday, Tuesday, Thursday and Friday at 10 a.m. Anniversary Masses can be included as usual throughout those times at any time that suits. It is also encouraged that perhaps those who may be a little nervous in the return can attend weekday Mass, where there will be less numbers of people, and that will fulfill indeed your obligation to attend Mass. For the weekend Masses, there will be some stewards to assist people in allocating their seats, their assigned seats, and to maximize the space and to ensure we follow the guidelines laid down. In the church, we also have hand sanitizing stations at each of the entrance doors, and an electrical spray sanitizer that is recommended use after every gathering so that the building is clean, sanitized, and safe for use at a later time. During the Mass, communion will be distributed as usual at the usual time, following safe and useful guidelines throughout. So we look forward to that, and please God, from tomorrow onwards, people will have the freedom to return to Mass, and we return to something of normal life. I thank our coordinating team for setting up the Mass from Kilcloon here this morning, and Pat and the girls for providing the music and the hymns for our Mass this morning. So thanks to you all, and we hope that today finds you well, and we look forward to a safe and cautious return to normal everyday activity, including our celebration of Mass and prayer together. So there will be the same details on our website, and maybe a reminder of Masses here on the YouTube channel as well during the coming week. So if you wish to access information there. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.